What's going on, guys? It's LateBomber. Welcome back to another video on the channel. Today, I will be showing you how to make a fashion show map in Fortnite Creative. A lot of you have been asking this on my last stream. Hello from the last stream if you guys were there. And yeah, anyways, guys, let's hit 1,000 subs by the end of this year, and let's get straight into this video. Alright, guys, first things first is you're going to want to open your galleries and grab any type of floor or anything that you want for your fashion show map. Alright, so what you're going to want to do is put that down just like so. Alright, let's start out with the hallway that they will be starting in when they are walking. Alright, so what you're going to want to do is you are going to want to, you know, make the hallway with whatever floor you're using. We'll make it one more long, just so people can fit. Alright, guys, so now we're going to add any door that you want and put that in. Alright, now let's make the hallway for it. So what you're going to want to do, you know, grab your own walls. You guys can design this however you want. So yeah, let's put the walls down. And add doors. So just make your full fashion show map, right? Alright, guys, now that you have the tunnel done just like that, now let's add some stairs to it. We're gonna use these stairs. No, they're not really stairs. Actually, I don't think you can climb up these. Nope. Alright, so we're gonna grab, I think we'll just grab these for stairs. You can use any stairs or anything you want. So build your fashion show. Alright, let's get building on the stage. Alright, guys, so we are done with the stage. I think I'm gonna cut that off just so we can see the people a little bit better. Alright, so now what you're gonna wanna do, put your walls down around the stage, just like so. Put your floor on top, just like that. Alright, so now I think we are going to extend this up by one, just like this. Whoops, do one more. Like that. Alright, now let's get building the people that are watching, the judges. Alright, so what you're going to want to do is put one bottom floor just like that. Take one just like this. And then we will be putting barriers right down here. So let's do this. And then put our barriers down. Alright, so now all you're gonna wanna do is change the height. We'll put it on 100 because, you know, you don't wanna just make it specific. Get this done as fast as we can. Alright, guys, now that we have the barriers in just like that, let's get into the building up here. So I recommend doing this and just putting one out just on that side, and then building like this, going just like this, and then putting the roof on top just like that. Alright, guys, so now let's get into the spawn area. First things first, we're going to make the room for the spawn area like that. That's good. Keep building. Alright, so now that we got the walls done just like that, let's get the floors down and the ceiling down.
Shadows in the atmosphere charting.
Alright guys, once you have that done, we'll do the ceiling in a second. We're gonna add the room with the secret entrance to get to the player room. So add that. Add this. Grab a trick tile. And set this right there. And now, if it's gonna let us customize it. Alright, looks like we're gonna have to do a different wall. Alright, we'll take a different wall for that one, since this is... That one's a little bit broken right now. Take this one. Alright. Now, let's set this down. Grab the trick tile. Now we can customize it. Put this on activation delay, none. Trigger and player contact to no. And then trigger when receiving from channel 100. Or no, channel 1. Alright, so now you're going to want to make your room in here. So what you're going to want to do is grab the score manager and place that down. I'll make it floating just like that. Alright, so you're going to want to put the score award type onto set. You're going to want to put the score, you're going to want to put the times the trigger to 1. Enable game face all, visible in game to yes, and then you're going to want to change this transmit on score to whatever number you want to open the wall. So I'm going to make it 12, and then on score output transmit to channel 1, boom. So now you're going to want to grab yourself a button. Put this on when you have to transmit on channel 2. Put this on to add. Put this on to score increment 1. And then increment when receiving from channel 2. Just like so. Take this, put it down again so it's green. Alright, so now let's get to the building of the ceiling of the main area. Alright guys, so now we are in the place where the trick tile is at. So what you're gonna wanna do here is you're going to want to find a mutator zone and place that down at the end, not like that, right at the end here. And you're going to want to put allow building, no. And you're gonna wanna go down to on player starts emoting, transmit on channel 3. And so now when that opens, you dance in here and it'll teleport you up here. So let's make the rift. So once you appear to the place where you want them to go, the judges, put the teleporter group none, that to none, and then no. Teleport to receiving from channel 3. And that's what you're gonna wanna do there. All right guys, so let's start building the buttons here. So first, we're gonna start off with the easiest button, the kill button. So you're gonna wanna put this down anywhere you'd like and put the interaction text onto kill and then put the when interacted transmit on channel 4 and click OK. So what you're gonna wanna do from there is, oops, let's put these down like that. All right, we already got that one. All right, so what you're gonna wanna do from there is put the damage volume right there. Take this, put that down, put the height on however long this goes to. You'll see a little line just like that. You want to make sure that goes all the way to the end there, and then all the way over here, which would be the width, do 6, just like that. So then when you, okay, so you want to put this onto enable that game start to no, enable when receiving from channel 4, disable when receiving from channel 5, and click OK. Now, grab yourself a trigger, put that down anywhere where you'll remember, and now let's do the settings. So this is pretty easy. Put trigger when receiving from channel 4, when triggered, transmit on channel 5, and put the delay on 2 seconds. Alright, now that we have that done, we are going to want to go to the, let's make another button. So we're going to make the good button, so send to next round. Put this on send to next round. And then put the when interacted with transmit on channel 6 and click OK.
Boy!
Alright, so once you have that done, what you're going to do is go to galleries, click the lights, and open the customizable light gallery and grab these lights right here. Let's do the settings for them. So what you're going to want to do is put them on green, turn on interact time, turn on team filter, none, turn these to none, and then turn the color to green, color change time to instant, initial state to off, color brightness to 10, and go down to turn on when receiving from channel 6, turn off when receiving from channel 7. Click OK. Now take these and put them inside just like this, where they fit on your walls. And then put them all around here. And then once you have them put down all around there, you have to be in a party for your voice to go through. Alright guys, so once you have that done, what you're going to want to do is put this. So whatever these lights are on right over here, you're going to want to put, so 6 and 7. You're going to want to put this trigger and just flip-flop these, put the delay on 5 seconds, put this on 6, and then this on 7. So now what you're going to want to do is grab a rift from the devices gallery and put it right here. So what you're going to want to do is put teleported group to none, teleported target group to group B, enable during phase all. You're going to want to put enable during phase pregame only, visual effects, teleported with visible, just put on all these on no. And then you're going to want to put enable when receiving from channel 8, disable when receiving from channel 9, click OK. Put these on 6 and 7. So now what you're going to want to do is go back, go to lights again, open this, grab a green A just right here, put that down, and put this on enable during phase pregame only, and then you're going to want to put this on enable when receiving from channel 6, disable when receiving from channel 7, just like that. Alright, and make sure you put that over the rift. So now take this rift that you have right here and put it up here where people can spectate, and change the rift to teleport a group to B, teleport a target group to none. And now make sure this one does not have these same settings, the 6 and 7. Put these on none, just like that. Alright, now you're going to want to put a barrier right here so they can't fall down. Put it on height, just like the death barrier we did. Make sure it reaches that side. And then make sure it gets to the other side. But you don't want it to go too far, because that could be, that is the, where the judges go. Alright, so it's just a little bit in the judges. So we'll do the width on swoop. Not seven. Five. There we go. Alright. So now that we have that done, that should be good for there. Alright, now let's add let's add the next round button. Alright, so when you have the next round button, put this and put start. We'll just put next round. Put this on when interacted with, transmit on channel 8, and click OK. Alright. So once you have that done, open another room up here where the people get teleported if they were sent to the next round. So now what you're going to want to do is grab another teleporter right here and put it on teleporter group to none, teleporter target group to group C. So now what you're going to want to do is put null, just like that. And then make sure the enable during phase is on pregame only. Put the enable when receiving from channel 8, disable when receiving from channel 9. So now copy this, go into this room down here. Put it to the rift at this very beginning, and change this to C, this to none, just like that. And then make sure this is on enable during phase all, and click OK. Then make sure you put enable, no channel there. Alright, so now let's get to the next player button. Actually, no, one more thing. We're gonna add a sign up here and a little message that'll go on people's screens so they know. Alright, so we're gonna put on here, next round has started. Go through this rift. Alright, so we put the text size on medium, fist on centered, outline I recommend putting on thick, show border to no, text color to green, background color to clear, and put this on the... So we have this, the next round button is on 8, so we're going to want to put this sign on, we're going to want to put it on enable during phase, pregame only, set text visible when receiving from channel 8, set text hidden when receiving from channel 9. Alright guys, so we have this trigger down here. Take that and change this to 30 seconds, change this to 8, change this to 9. So now we have that set up. The rifts, remember, should have disabled 9, just like that. So make sure that is on 30 seconds. Alright guys, now we're going to want go to the next player, so the door opens. I think we're going to pull this one forward, just like that. Alright, first things first, you're going to want to grab yourself a lock device and put it down just in front of the door. And then it held check mark. Alright, put visible in game to off, starts locked, yes. Open when receiving from channel 10, close when receiving from channel 11, and click OK. So now we're going to add a button that says next player. Alright, so we're going to want to put this on 10 and click OK. So now we're going to once again take another trigger. Put the delay on 3 seconds, put this on 10, and put this on 11. And now let's get to the spawn pads. So what you're going to want to do is put, spawn pads down, put 16 of them down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. All right. Actually, I think that was 15, so we'll put 16 down just like that. All right. So now you want to make sure they all go through the door and the password is a secret. All right. So now let's get into the settings. What you're gonna wanna do, actually, okay, right before the settings, just in case some sneaky person decides to come through the rift, put a combat shotgun in an item spawner secretly back here. Items respond to off, put this on instant, and then that should be it. All right, so I recommend putting a combat shotgun because these are pretty quick shooting guns. And then just set that in here just in case somebody goes through that rift in the beginning because they figure out your secret thing. All right, so now let's get into the settings of the fashion show map. All right, so put voice chat onto all, spawn limit onto one, total rounds to whatever you want, time limit to none, and that should be it. Alright guys, so now, sorry about that. Alright, so now what you guys are gonna want to do is go to settings. Time of day, I recommend putting on early in the morning, like 11 a.m. So then it's a little bit lighter in there. Alright, starting health, put one health, max health, one health. Starting shields, 100% shield, no shield. So we can put that on no. Infinite ammo on, infinite resources off, maximum building resources to zero. Allow aim assist, yes. Allow building, none. Allowed to edit default, building can destroy environment, no. Environment damage off, structure damage, none. Weapon destruction, zero, none. Pickaxe destruction, none. PvP pickaxe damage off. Eliminated players items, delete. Allow item drop, yes or no, that's up to you. Allow item pickup, yes. Respawn time, doesn't matter. Fall damage, no. Gravity, normal. Jump fatigue, glider redeploy to off. Team only. And that should be it for, put allow manual spawning to no, 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 no. And then yeah, so that's it for that. Put these on 3 seconds. And that should be it. If you guys want to know how to make an item shop, I'll be showing you right now. If you guys don't want to make an item shop for your thing, feel free to... Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you want an item shop just like this inside there, I bet you can find it in another fashion show tutorial. They're pretty easy. So basically, I'll show you guys right now. Alright guys, so I'm gonna show you how to do a item shop just right here like this. Alright, so what you're gonna wanna do is grab vending machines and grab a vending machine, place it down, and make it pretty small. Just like that. And then put your any items that you want in for the fashion show like that. I'm not going to show you putting in every gun in every vending machine or every item in every vending machine. That's up to you guys. So put your vending machines inside this a little room that you made here. And so now what you're going to want to do is grab a barrier, put that down, and put it on translucent just like that so you can see that it's closed. Make sure you put enable during phase all, and you're gonna want to put the disable when receiving from channel 12. So now what you're gonna wanna do, if you have an item shop, go here, go up to here, put another button down that says open item shop. and put it on one interactive with the transmit on channel 12. Alright, so there's two more things I want to do. One, the first thing, alright, so they both include the HUD message device. You're gonna wanna put these close to your triggers, just so you know. Alright, put this on time from on start to off, display time to 3 seconds. This one's gonna be item shop. So put it on item shop is now open. And click OK, just like that. All right, and don't play around with these. Placement, top center, show when receiving from channel 12, and click OK. So now what you're gonna want to do is the Rift one. So put the next round has started. Go through the Rift. All right, so now that you have that, keep it on the same, turn this to off, this to, I would say 10 seconds, and then put this down to 8. Make sure you put show when receiving from channel 8, not hide when receiving from channel 8. All right. So that is pretty much it for today's tutorial video. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and I will see you guys next time. Peace out.